No, I don't think I can't think of any nothing in my life in terms of stuff that's been very funny. Oh, occasionally I've had some rather weird accidents. When once a pigeon was flying over the skylight in my loft, and happened to do something one of his little no-nos on my sculpture at the time. And there's something about the quality of this bird no-no, which made the whole sculpture like something very, very eternal and a cycle which is always going on. Well, I had a bit of trouble when I first tried to show it to the Parc Bonnet, because the secretary went out with a handkerchief over her nose. I thought it was rather indelicate of her because, you know, artists have always put up with hardships. Usually I wake up at around 7 o'clock in the morning. Or if I can, I wake up at 6 o'clock to go back to see sunrise. Because there's something I feel very stimulated by it. I always do my exercise. I've been practicing, I practice yoga in my spare time. For a while, I was a Zen Buddhist, but I couldn't stand the idea of the small diet, which you have to have when you're a Zen Buddhist. And also the lotus position gave me kinks in the knees. Matter of fact, I am in some yoga. Every once in a while, my wife makes a mistake of trying to break into my yoga exercises, and it's impossible for me to break out of them. I wouldn't, and I can't. The mornings are usually the happiest time of the day, because they're fun. My wife cooks up great things. It's a feast every morning. There's bacon, eggs, and pancakes. There's a lot of syrup, butter, sausages sometimes, cereal, orange juice, milk, coffee, and cocoa. You have to have a big breakfast in order to get your system working. We start talking as soon as I get up. She starts, she'll be talking about books or movies or things like that. And I'll start talking about the relationship to art. Talk about how Mickey Rooney or Humphrey Bogart. And I can wind up with talking about the sculpture that I'm ready to do.
by the time I get out of the house, I'm so full of ideas that I can't wait to get to the studio.
There is no such thing as an accident in art. Let me make that clear. Accidents don't happen. They are gifts. So, some of the best things in art ever have come about through lucky accidents. My art particularly has been filled with the greatest sorts of accidents that any artist could hope for. I get to New York whenever I can. If you want to go into the core and you need a little of that old lightning which gets you going again, builds the juices up, gives you your old wahoo, you've got to go into New York.
Well, sometimes when you're walking through the streets in New York City, you'll come across the worst, most abhorrent pieces of art you could ever imagine. It's sort of stuff you want to turn around and go down the other way. Get some whitewash guy or painter or something to just cover it over with blue polka dots or something. I go to New York very often, mainly because there are the Park Bonnet galleries are there, and they're my dealers. And I think Park Bonnet, for me, is the center of New York. Whenever I go there, that's where I immediately go. It's almost my first stop. Well, I'd like to think that I'm not going to settle for a second best. I'm not sorry for the chickens in art at all. I see no compassion for them whatsoever. Because what you got, you have to shoot for the top. And Park Bonnet, to me, is the top. And they treat me as if I'm the top. Oh, I will admit that Park Bonnet has put off the work that I've been doing and for a later period when I can show it in full book, in full completeness of the forms that it needs to represent. No. Whether or not you think about what's going to happen to you when you get to heaven, or if there is a heaven, or if there's a God, or anything like that, whether or not you think about it, the only thing worthwhile, the only thing that's worth even working for, is to be able to build something that is eternal, so that you can that you yourself last throughout the time of man. Because if you don't, then what's the sense of doing of living? And so I hope to make some sculpture which would be able to be an eternal monument. It's going to last through the ages, undestroyed by sand or anything like that.
I'll be able to correct the vision of the American people. I think that I have the third eye, the X-ray vision, which is going to be able to completely get the people revivified. I think of myself as the Pegasus, on which everybody else is going to fly. On their wings, which is going to make them soar. And when they watch my sculpture, and when they look at the stuff, they're going to see that.